Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. And today in this video we are going to see about one of the major building construction, that is windows. And let us get into the topic. So windows, we all know about the windows. So it is an opening in the wall of the building to serve the functions like natural light, natural ventilation, vision purposes. And if possible, windows should be located on the northern side, and it is not possible in nowadays where the windows could not be kept only at the northern side. And if possible, the location of the window could be on the northern side is very very best. And the windows should be placed opposite to each other wherever possible. If the window is in the northern side, the another window could be kept the straight opposite to the southern side, so that the air could flow very easily. And the sill of the window should be kept at a height of 0.75 to 1 meter where the windows could be placed. And if you want to achieve the privacy purposes, the sill level could be raised to 2 meters also. And coming to the thumb rules of the windows, the total area of the window opening should be at least 15% of the floor area of the room, and the window opening should be equal to 20% of the floor area. And the breadth of the window should be 1/8 of the width of the room plus height of the room. And the total area of the glass panels, you could see the glass panels in the windows. So such glass panels should have the total area of at least 10% of the floor area. And these are the thumb rules should be kept in the mind for the construction of the windows, and for also while constructing the walls of the rooms. And we are all not dealing with the components of the windows, because the components of window is same as the components of doors, which was dealt with the past videos itself. So now getting into the classifications of the windows, first of all we will deal with the based on operations. So the first one is the fixed window. The fixed window is only for lighting purposes, not for air purposes. It is fixed and it is not at all movable. So next is the horizontal sliding window. Horizontal sliding window could move only in the horizontal direction. And next coming to the casement window. Casement window is could be seen nowadays that corners are hinged and it is movable outside or swinging inside also. So next coming to the folding windows. Folding windows could be like the folding doors. So numbers of windows could be folded in a horizontal direction. And pivoted window is hinged at the middle, where for lighting purposes and also for the privacy purposes, pivoted window could be used. And top or bottom hinged windows, so in kitchen purposes or any other AC buildings, like office buildings, you could see this top or bottom hinged windows, which is used in nowadays. And also there is a gel house windows. It is not used nowadays because of it is very not possible to cleaning daily. So it could be seen in the ventilation purposes, for the bathrooms, for the toilets and kitchens. And you could see this awning window, you could see the changes between these two windows, because these have number of panels and these have very less number of panels. And this could be seen in the areas where privacy is very very important. And these are all about the based on operation. And next you could see about the based on location. So the first one is the bay window. These windows projecting outwards outside the external wall of the room, and you could see in this picture it is facing outward. And increase the area of the opening, admit it also increases the area of the opening, admit more light and ventilations in the different directions. So next one is the corner window. Corner windows are provided for the ventilation and lighting from the two directions, that is right angle, and it also improve the appearance of the building. You could see in this picture the windows which is at the corner, it improves the appearance and it is very good to see. And also the ventilations and lights are very well planned. So the next one is the gable window. These windows are provided in the gable end of the sloping roof. So you could see this gable point in the roofing portions. So just now you could see that gable is the one of the area in this sloping roof. So here you could see the window. This is called gable windows. The next one is the dormer window. The gable windows and dormer windows are similarly equal, but these are all vertical window building on the sloping sides of sloping roof. Projecting window, it is a projecting window, it is very very important. So the projecting windows on the sloping sides of the pitched roof. You could see the dormer window is projecting outwards, but gable windows are not projected outwards. Lanterns or lantern light window. These are the windows fixed in the flat roof for lightning passage only. So you could see in this picture, this is a lantern window only for lightning, not for the ventilation, not for the air entering purposes. Only for lightning purposes, the lantern windows are kept. So in order to increase more lightning and also for privacy point of view, you could not use these lantern windows in the houses, but you could see these types of houses, these types of windows in offices, hotels, hostels, etc. Skylight window, you could see these windows in many of the films or movies. So windows usually fixed in the sloping roof of the roof parallel to its inclinations. So you could move this one and you could allow the air into it. So this is called skylight window. It is very very useful if you are moving into the roofed buildings. And the last one is the clerestory window, usually provided near the top of the main roof. You could see this is the main roof and this is the side roof, and you could see the between space is filled with the clerestory windows. So usually pivoted windows is used. Pivoted windows are hinged at the top, hinged at the middle. So such types of windows could be used in the clerestory window. This would increases the appearance of the buildings, and also it allows the natural lightning into the buildings. So, and that's all for today's videos, friends. If you like this video, thumbs up for my video, give your suggestions in the comment box, and subscribe my YouTube channel to get the regular videos, and also press the bell button. Thank you, friends. Meet you on the next video.